Oral white lesions are white-coloured areas of abnormality on the soft tissues of the mouth. These include the lips, tongue, cheeks, and gums. These lesions can either be harmless and temporary, or be indicative of an underlying primary concern. When it comes to oral white lesions, they can result from a range of underlying conditions, each with its own distinct cause. Leukoplakia, for instance, is typically associated with constant irritation resulting from tobacco or alcohol consumption. Oral candidiasis, on the other hand, occurs due to an overgrowth of the candida fungus. There is also lichen planus, which is an autoimmune disorder, and oral hairy leukoplakia is another one, which occurs from an infection from the Epstein-Barr virus. Furthermore, it is imperative to acknowledge that some white lesions may have the potential to progress into cancerous conditions. This heightened risk is influenced by a range of factors. Firstly, the consumption of tobacco and alcohol, both known for their irritant effects, immune-suppressing properties, and carcinogenic nature. These can collectively contribute to the manifestations of conditions such as oral leukoplakia or oral squamous cell carcinoma. Additionally, chronic irritants such as poorly fitting dentures can induce thickening of the oral epithelium, ultimately leading to a condition referred to as frictional keratosis. Furthermore, a weakened immune system further increases the susceptibility to infections and impairs wound healing. And lastly, poor oral hygiene can result in the accumulation of microorganisms in the oral cavity and directly increases the risk of conditions like oral candidiasis. In diagnosing oral white lesions, we begin with patient history and a comprehensive clinical examination, assessing the appearance, location, size of lesion and associated symptoms, as well as understanding the patient's habits. We also check if the lesion can be scraped off. Additional tests include biopsies for tissue analysis, microbial cultures for infections, and blood tests for systemic involvement. If the diagnosis remains unclear or specialized care is required, a referral to a specialist is necessary. Management of oral white lesions is dependent on the diagnosis and the likely prognosis of the lesion. For example, in leukoplakia and frictional keratosis, removal of the causative agent is required if it is known. Essentially, if there's an improperly fitting denture, then that's removed, or if there's tobacco consumption, then that is ceased. For oral candidiasis, as another example, antifungal medications are prescribed, whilst corticosteroids are provided in the event of lichen planus. To summarize, oral white lesions are white-colored patches in the oral cavity that are caused by a variety of sources and may be precancerous. Diagnosis usually involves a thorough medical history, clinical examination, biopsy, and additional tests. Management is based on the underlying condition and causative agents, with certain diagnoses requiring prescription medications and others requiring removal of the causative agent. Sometimes surgical intervention may be required.